Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Dom, and today we are checking out the top 10 free jailbreak tweaks for iOS 7, and these are all included in the default Cydia repositories. Actually, I think all of them are in the Big Boss repo, so go ahead and check them out. But the first one we are taking a look at is Jelly Lock 7, and this is a lock screen replacement that will allow you to put up to 5 of your favorite apps right there for quick access on the lock screen. And if you want to access one, just slide up to it. And as you can see, we opened up Instagram. And if you press the home button, you are taken back to the lock screen. So it's kind of a secure way to easily allow access to certain apps on your lock screen. We also do have some settings for Jelly Lock 7. As you can see here, we have the ability to enable or disable it. We can also change the app shortcuts that are found on the lock screen up to 5, like I said. And we can enable or disable skip passcode. So if you don't want people to be able to access apps from the lock screen without entering a passcode, you do also have that option, along with appearance options, as you can see right here. So that is Jelly Lock 7, and like I said, it's a pretty cool lock screen replacement, and it's pretty amazing that it's available for free given all the options that you have here. So go ahead and check it out. Again, this is Jelly Lock 7. Next up, we are checking out Color Your Board Free, and there is also a pro version of this tweak available, so keep that in mind if you want to support the developer and get additional features. But both versions will install this app on your home screen, and inside of here you'll see that we have this nice little color wheel. But if we try to use that, it will give us this little message letting us know that we need to have the pro version. But we do have the option to choose from these colors down here at the bottom, so that works fine in this area. So let's go ahead and choose a color real quick. All we have to do is tap on save, make sure we close out of the app that we want to see the color keyboard appear in, and then we can go ahead and back out. Let's launch the notes app here. That's the one I was using. Tap on the text area, and as you can see, we have a red keyboard here. So that is how Color Your Board Free works. It's pretty plain and simple. And like I said, there's not very many options in the free version, but it does get the job done if you're looking for a way to spice up your keyboards in iOS 7. Next on the list, we are checking out Icon Lock 7. And this tweak will prevent others from moving around your apps and deleting them. So once you have it installed, you'll be prompted to set up a passcode here. I've already set it up, so I'm gonna go ahead and enter that to unlock Icon Lock 7's preferences. So here you have the ability to enable or disable it and change the password, and that's just about it. So let me show you how this works here. As we try to put an icon into wiggle mode, we are prompted to enter a passcode from Icon Lock 7. Once you've entered the correct passcode, you will have the ability now to move the app icons or delete specific apps if you would like. It's not a very complex tweak, but it does offer an alternative to setting up restrictions to prevent people from deleting apps, and like I said, it also does prevent them from moving them around. So this is Icon Lock 7. It's a pretty bare bones tweak, but it is available for free. So go ahead and check it out. Moving along here, we are taking a look at Flip Control Center, an awesome tweak that will allow you to customize the toggles found in Control Center. So as you can see here, we have Control Center pulled up, but if we swipe over, we do have other options available. Now we can completely customize these options within the settings app. So as you can see here, we have the ability to move these up and down within the list to customize them to our liking, so we can add or remove them just like that. We can also suppress certain ones from being able to be activated on the lock screen. So if you don't want airplane mode to be able to turn on when you're on the lock screen, then you can go ahead and check that there and you'll be all set and ready to go. Overall, it's a pretty simple tweak, but it does offer a ton of functionality and it's 100% free, so you really can't go wrong with that if you're looking for a great way to customize Control Center. Next up, we are taking a look at Pass Dial, and consider this speed dial for your passcode keypad on iOS 7. This will allow you to customize up to 3 different numbers, and there is also a pro version that allows for 10 different numbers, and you can set a passcode for each one. So for example, we can go ahead and enter a passcode on the lock screen, 1234, and we should dial that 555 number that I have set for number 1. So let's go ahead and try it out here. We'll swipe over, enter in that passcode that I set up, and immediately it begins dialing the number that I specified within the settings app. So it's a pretty cool tweak, and I really do enjoy it actually. It helps you access numbers on the fly right from your lock screen without having to unlock them and launch the phone app and things like that. So go ahead and check it out. It's called Pass Dial and it's available in the Big Boss repo for free. If you're looking for an easy way to customize the lock screen, Lockify may be the tweak for you. This is available in the Big Boss repo for free and it will allow you to hide various elements on the lock screen. So as you can see in the settings app here, if we select different options, they will immediately hide on the lock screen. It's pretty much that simple. So let's go ahead and back out to the lock screen and try this out. And as you can see here, we have hidden the date and we have moved the time to the status bar. Very, very simple stuff. But if you're not a fan of all the clutter on the lock screen, it will give you the option to hide that. Like I said, it's a free tweak, so you really can't ask for much more. It's pretty awesome for being free. Go ahead and check it out. This one is called Lockify. Up next, we are checking out Ina, and this is a free tweak that will put a quick mirror on your iOS 7 device. Now, all you have to do to activate Ina once it's installed is hold down on the camera grabber on the lock screen or the camera icon within Control Center, and you'll have this little mirror pop up, as you can see right here. Now, the advantage to using Ina over, let's say, the stock camera app is that you don't have all of that user interface cluttering the screen, so you'll have a full screen mirror for your face or whatever you want to look at in Ina. And like I said, you can tap and hold on the camera grabber on the lock screen or the camera icon in Control Center, and then tap on that little yellow triangle to dismiss it when you're done. Moving along here, we are taking a look at Status Bar Suite, and this will allow you to hide different elements on the status bar. So inside of the settings app here, you'll have various options, and when I installed it at first, they were all enabled, so go ahead and disable them all at first, and you may need to respring to get that to kind of reset itself. But once you're all finished here, you can go ahead and select any options you'd like and then respring, and you're all set and ready to go. And as you can see, I've completely hidden the status bar at the top, so that results in some full screen app action for myself. But you can do this with other options as well. We can hide the battery, the carrier, the time, basically anything that shows up on the status bar, you have the ability to hide with Status Bar Suite. It's a very simple tweak, but again, it offers tons of functionality in here for you to customize the look and feel of your iOS 7 device. And as you can see, I've hidden the battery up there, so we no longer have the battery icon, just the percentage. So go ahead and check it out. This is called Status Bar Suite, and it's available in the Big Boss repo for free. This next tweak will allow you to customize your folders, and yep, it's called Folder Customizer. I mean, it's a pretty obvious name there. It will allow you to change the color of the folders, the font, the background, the label, everything like that. And now it doesn't really give you any options to see which color you're changing it to. You just have these RGB sliders, and then you can respring the device. But as you can see right here, I've changed the color of the folder to red, and well, that's pretty much it. This is Folder Customizer. Go ahead and check it out. Finally, we are taking a look at Message Swiper 7, and this will allow you to swipe between threads within the Messages app by SMS or iReal SMS. And I recommend that you change the swipe start from to the center instead of edges due to how iOS 7 works for swiping backwards between applications. So as you can see here, once we have that set up, we can swipe between these threads with left and right swipes just like that. It's a very, very simple tweak, but it is very effective. And if you're looking for a quick way to browse through your messages, well, this just might be the solution. So I hope you enjoyed this video. These are my top 10 free tweaks for February 2014. They're all compatible with iOS 7 and 64-bit devices. Go ahead and check them out and let me know what you think in the comments section below. Also, leave this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, as it does help out the channel a lot, and be sure to subscribe for more content like this in the future. Thanks again for watching, everybody. This is Dom, and have a great day.